Herb Ryman, one of Walt Disney's most talented and legendary artists, visualized much of the look of the Magic Kingdom, and a dream became a reality. Here's a remarkable behind-the-scenes tour into the Disney art archives, as well as a place where Herb's inspiration lives on.
Carefully cataloged and digitally stored, this database holds the magic work and creativity of the artists of Disney, including one of the original greats, Herbert Ryman.
So this is saying that there's 784 pieces of art that Herbie did.
Here in this temperature-controlled room in a nondescript building, the work itself. And now a glimpse rarely seen, including the drawing that started it all. A tour hosted by Michael Jusk, principal art archivist and Disney legend, former principal creative executive of Walt Disney Imagineering, Marty Sklar.
You could come back here and do a manual search. It's all arranged by park and land and attraction. But when you get into a case of a large attraction like the Haunted Mansion, it has many, many drawers, and you don't want to go through each one of those drawers, each one of those pieces of art to come across something. So in the database, it'll tell you go to directly to this drawer. That's where that piece of art is stored. It's very handy.
You know, when I come in here, this is so exciting to be able to see all these panels that Mike has. And you know, for example, here's Herb Ryman's first sketch of the castle for Walt Disney World.
I'm going to show you the drawing that Herb Ryman did with Walt Disney at his side that they completed in the course of a weekend so that Roy, like I said, could go to New York and talk to the bankers and pitch this whole concept that was Disneyland. Remember, this is drawn in a single weekend.
Adam, one man's head and one artist's wrist. It is amazing. It just, you can sit here for hours and study this, and all pencil drawings. And this was, it must have been in his head developing for years to be able to pour that out in one weekend. I mean, to me, that's the most incredible thing, is that all of that was in this man's head. But this was rolled up, and Roy took it to New York, and it sold the project.
I can't imagine the bankers had much imagination, so.
That's exactly what Walt said to Roy, to Herb, I'm sorry. Exactly what Walt said to Herbie, the bankers have no imagination, we have to show them what we're gonna do. There's a few things in here that are kind of fun. You know, at one time Walt considered putting a church in here. Walk down this corridor here with Mike, okay. And he'll open up,
walk down that corridor with Mike.
So we're walking down the Disneyland aisle. This is where all the Disneyland artwork is stored in these flat files. So this drawer contains concept artwork done for Pirates of the Caribbean at Disneyland. So here's the mayor being dunked in the well. Mm-hmm. Carlos, don't tell them.
When did you join, Ryan?
Oh, I started a month before Disneyland opened.
Okay.
1955, but I started working at Imagineering on the New York World's Fair things, 1961.
Were there few enough of you that you all hung out together, or was it already so large of a group of people that sometimes you never knew who was doing what?
Well, when we started on the World's Fair, 1960, 61, we had 100 people here. When we were working on Epcot and Tokyo Disneyland at the same time in the late 70s and early 80s, we had 3,000 people here.
Here in row after row, safely tucked away, the good, the grand, and the never to happen.
Ooh, here's a...
Oh, that's the thing that never happened.
Yeah.
It's a Rolly Cromp Museum of the Weird. The aquarium with ghost fish.
lot of detail in there.
Walt wanted to do something called Big Rock Candy Mountain, and they actually built it out of candy. And one day everybody walked in and said, "Oh my God, I'm just getting sick working on this." And so Walt said, "Let's not do it." So they put the model outside and the crows ate it. But that location became the Matterhorn.
The remarkable legacy and achievement of all the talented artists who helped create this extraordinary world cannot be measured. But Marty Sklar and others decided not to just look back at the magic of Herb Ryman, but to create something that would keep his vision alive for years to come.
Herb's friends and family said there's got to be a way to honor this man with a kind of living tribute that would reflect his values and his passion, really, for mentoring young artists and for really passing on the fundamentals of drawing and painting.
You know, he was a graduate of the Chicago Art Institute and really believed that an artist has to understand, have the foundation skills. You can't just say, do your own thing. You have to have the foundation skills to be able to draw and paint. And that's how we started the Ryman Arts Program.
If you knew how to draw well and could, you know, translate what you saw to your head, to your heart, to your hand, as he often spoke, that would really take you far. And so his friends and family in 1990 started with just 12 kids in a room and said, let's just try out the idea of having a kind of master drawing class for high school age kids who have real potential. And now, 23 years later, we are serving 300 kids a year in this intense program and have almost 5,000 graduates across the country over our history now pursuing the arts professionally in so many different kinds of fields.
Well, he was a role model and an inspiration for young artists because, I mean, look at this. How could you not be inspired by it?
You can learn more about Herb Ryman at RymanArts.org.
And that wraps it up for this edition of LA Art.
For more arts and culture, visit us online. Until next time, I'm Raymond Lee.
And I'm Katie Hall. Thanks for watching.